7:45. What effect does being unemployed have on young people? There's a report out today by the Prince's Trust charity, which doesn't make for happy reading. More than half of unemployed young people often feel anxious about everyday situations. Many also try to avoid meeting new people because of low self-esteem, presumably, and struggle to make eye contact. Let's speak to Paul Brown from the Prince's Trust and also 23-year-old Nat Hawley, who's been unemployed and was helped by the Trust. Good morning to you both. Thank you for joining us this morning. This report was based on interviews with about 2,000 young people. What's the background to it, Paul?
Yeah, so this is the seventh year we've conducted the Prince's Trust Macquarie Youth Index, and it's the biggest survey of its kind. It seeks to find out how happy young people are with their lives today and how confident they feel about the future. And it shows that while most young people are happy with most aspects of their lives, there are a significant minority who are experiencing a whole range of mental health and emotional well-being issues.
An overwhelming feeling of anxiety amongst young employed people. That's quite sad, isn't it?
Yeah, overall, you know, one in 10 or so young people said they regularly feel too anxious to leave their homes. But if you look at the unemployed young people, that rises to a third of that community. And across the whole survey, it seems that unemployed young people are more likely to be less happy with most aspects of their lives. And that's a real concern for us.
And Nat's there, I believe. Is Nat with you at the moment?
Yeah. Hey, yeah.
Hi, Nat. Can you tell us what it was like for you and that feeling of low self-esteem that comes with not having a purpose, I suppose, not having a job?
Well, it's one of, like, well, for me, the worst feeling I probably have felt in my life. It's like, you wonder what's the point of getting up in the mornings, you wonder what's the point, you start to question your own existence. Everyone likes to feel useful, a part of something, and to get up in the morning and feel a positiveness, but when you've got anxiety and depression through not having a work or something to do, it can make everyday tasks that extra challenge.
And I suppose then it starts a sort of downward spiral that it's really hard to get out of.
Definitely. I mean, once you start sleeping in one day because you're too scared of what the day may encounter, then it escalates, and before you know it, you could have dropped out of education. You become less and less likely each day to get a job, and it's really hard to get out of that downhill spiral.
And Paul, the report also found that while a fifth of young people admit to falling apart emotionally on a regular basis, this does increase to a third of young unemployed people.
That's right, and I think it's worth remembering that young people who left school last summer spent their entire time in secondary school against the backdrop of the longest sustained global downturn in living memory. Can you imagine that pressure? Many of them just don't have the hope that they'll achieve anything in the future, but at the Prince's Trust we believe they do. We believe they've all got talents and we need to help them unearth those.
What can be done to help, Paul?
Well, there's lots of support out there. I think a lot of young people who are struggling, particularly if their confidence has taken a knock, they don't know where to turn for support. But if they go to their local information centre, they go online, they could call the Prince's Trust. Our programmes are there to help. The programmes are free and there's a really positive chance of success. 3 in 4 young people on our programmes move into education, employment or training.
And Nat, just finally to you, how did you break that cycle? How did you improve your situation?
Well, to kind of get out of that spiral, it really is not easy. But with the help of organisations like the Trust that helped me regain my confidence by slowly integrating me back into society, I met new young people, I did courses which allowed me to explore who I was, so I was able to come out of my shell. And the main bit of advice I'd give to young people is that know that thousands of other people just like you go through this. You're not alone.
Thank you for joining us, Nat Hawley and Paul Brown from the Prince's Trust. Paul, where do we get more information from?
Yeah, search for the Prince's Trust online or give us a call at 9 o'clock this morning, and we'd be really happy to give advice and help.
Thank you for joining us both. It's Lizzie and Carl on Radio Humberside.
Sports news from James Hand and more news headlines from me in 15 minutes.
Good morning, Jersey, with Ashley Tracy and James Hand.
On BBC Radio Jersey. 27 minutes to 9 o'clock. Now, we heard in the news yesterday that people under the age of 25 continue to account for about a quarter of all job seekers in Jersey. But what effect does being unemployed have on young people? Well, according to the Prince's Trust charity, more than half of unemployed young people often feel anxious about everyday situations. Many also avoid meeting new people and struggle to make eye contact. Well, we can talk now to Paul Brown from the Prince's Trust and 23-year-old Nat Hawley, who's been unemployed and was helped by the Trust. We'll speak to you first, Paul. Morning to you. Just briefly, briefly talk us through what you found here.
So this is the seventh year we've conducted the Prince's Trust Macquarie Youth Index, and it measures how happy young people are with their lives today and how confident they feel about the future. The good news, first of all, is that most young people are happy with most aspects of their lives. But there are a sizable minority of young people who actually experience a range of mental health and emotional well-being issues, and those problems are particularly acute amongst the unemployed.
I suppose many people will find it surprising that unemployed people, you know, suffer from mental health issues and stuff. It's not two things you'd necessarily think go hand in hand. Are you surprised by these findings?
I'm not surprised, but the figures do paint a fairly stark picture. So, for example, if you look at all young people, around 1 in 10 say they often feel too anxious to leave their own home. If you look amongst the unemployed young people, it actually reaches 1 in 3. So those young people who perhaps have never had their chance for their first job, many of them have hit rock bottom, and we need to pick them up, boost their skills and confidence, and help them get into work.
Now, you've also got Nat Hawley with you, who's 23 and I believe who has been unemployed and was helped out by the Trust. Nat, just talk us through how it felt to you being at that age and being unemployed.
Being unemployed when you're young and you've left education, you just feel kind of lost, like there's no real purpose in life. You've had that kind of structure, that stability your whole life, and once that disappears, you're left empty, and that can lead to depression, like low self-worth, and it just makes kind of getting up in the morning really difficult.
People will inevitably listen to this and say people have to look for jobs, they have to work hard for jobs, they have to try to get them. Is it more difficult than that?
Do you know, I wish it was that simple, I really do. You can have all the qualifications in the world, but if the jobs aren't out there, they're hard to find. And even if there are jobs available, if you don't have the self-worth or the self-belief that you can do it, then you won't be able to get to that level to be able to find a job.
So was it a case of feeling like you were in a rut and you just couldn't see the other side? You couldn't see how you get out of it?
Yeah, exactly. I kept thinking like I wasn't really good enough for anything, that even if I was to get a job, I'd fail at it, that I wouldn't be able to cope with it, that the strains and the pressures of everyday life. As well as getting a job, there's always so many other issues to consider, like family life, disabilities, like your education level, that a lot of young people have.
Paul, just back to you briefly. Is what Nat's saying reflective of what you found across the board?
Yeah, we meet young people at the Prince's Trust every day who... they have complex, chaotic lives and experience a range of issues. But what we do know is that if we give them the support they deserve, often in the long term, they can turn their lives around and achieve fantastic things like Nat has. At the end of our programmes, more than 3 in 4 young people have a positive outcome and they move into education, employment or training.
What effect does being unemployed have on young people? According to the Prince's Trust charity, more than half of unemployed young people often feel anxious about everyday situations. Many avoid meeting new people and struggle to make eye contact. The report's based on interviews with more than 2,000 young people aged between 16 and 25. Paul Brown is from the Prince's Trust with 23-year-old Nat Hawley, who's been unemployed and was helped by the Trust, and we can talk to them now. Paul, first of all, good morning.
Good morning.
Tell us more about the figures and how they relate to unemployment then.
Yeah, so this is the seventh year we've conducted the Prince's Trust Macquarie Youth Index, and it measures how happy young people are with their lives today and how confident they feel about the future. And the good news is that most young people are generally happy with their lives, but a significant minority do seem to experience a wide range of mental health and emotional well-being issues. And what's very clear is unemployed young people are less happy with every aspect of their lives.
Is it getting worse?
In general, the youth index has been stable over the last 7 years, but we've seen in the last 2 years in particular, quite a steep decline in the happiness and confidence amongst unemployed young people. So it does appear, as the economy seems to be recovering for most of us,
it's
for those young people who've been left behind because they've never had the chance to get a job, their well-being does seem to be taking quite a dive.
Let's bring Nat in. Nat, good morning.
Morning.
How long were you unemployed?
I was unemployed for... Well, up until recently, I've never had a proper job, to be honest. I've been kind of in and out of education as well as being a young carer, so I never really got a chance to have a job.
And how did you feel on a day-to-day basis?
On a day-to-day basis, I just kind of felt alone and isolated. Like, there was no one really there to support me or kind of understood the struggles that I was going through at the time.
And how did the trust help you?
The trust helped me by... well, they found me when I was at my lowest and they picked me up and I went on one of their programs, which kind of taught me how to be confident with who I am. They gave me a chance to be around other young people who have similar issues as myself. So finally, I had someone I could really chat to, and I did courses in mental health, awareness, cooking, financing, and really fun stuff like canoeing and kayaking, which for someone who's pretty much scared to leave the front door, it was incredible, and it gave me the world of confidence.
And where are you now? What are you doing now?
Well, I've now just recently graduated university and just moved to London, and I've now work as a job ambassador for the Trust, helping young people that just like how I was.
And let's bring Paul back in. What does the Trust propose then in terms of tackling this problem, Paul?
Well, as the economy recovers, the general levels of youth unemployment are starting to fall, but it seems the news agenda and to some extent the political agenda has moved on. So we're taking today to remind people there are still 750,000 young people who are unemployed. We think we should all redouble our efforts to make sure we give them the support to tackle the underlying issues in their lives and get their skills and confidence ready to get their crucial first job.
Paul, thank you very much. Paul Brown from the Prince's Trust, and Nat Hawley, 23 years old. He's been unemployed and was helped by the Trust. More than half, of unemployed young people feel anxious about everyday situations, avoid meeting new people and struggle to make eye contact. It can be a downward spiral, and the Prince's Trust trying to help them get out of it.
Kate Rosby and the Village Green Preservation Society, the theme to Jam in Jerusalem, and more of your WI stories to come through the show. Now, we were talking earlier in the last hour about a new study by the Prince's Trust that has found more than 1 in 10 young people often feel too anxious to leave the house. And you may well have heard from our guest Sean Milne, who was on the show in the last hour, and indeed from Erica Roberts, our Julian's person, who is an older person's chaplain, who says actually it's not just youngsters, but it's older people as well who feel isolated. And today we're asking in our big conversation, could we do more to stop people becoming isolated? We were so impressed with Sean that we've asked him to come back and stay with us through until 10 o'clock. Sean, good morning.
Thank you, Julian.
Thank you for being there. You really inspired me, you know, in the last hour, so thank you for being there this morning. Sean's story, as he was saying in the last hour, he basically didn't go out a lot or enough, got sort of dragged down by a drink problem, which he's now cured, thanks to the Prince's Trust, and he's with us through the show. We're now joined, actually, in our London studio by Paul Brown from the Prince's Trust and Nat Hawley, who's a 23-year-old who's also been helped by the Prince's Trust. And I gather Nat is from Eastleigh. So it's a very small world, I've decided. Morning, Paul. Morning, Nat.
Morning.
Good morning.
Thanks for being there. And obviously, Sean is here as well, so good morning to all three of you. Paul, can I come to you first? I was shocked by this statistic. A good sample size, by the way, in your research as well. Mm. 1 in 10 not going out. 40% of youngsters feel anxious about everyday situations.
Yeah, this is the 7th year we've conducted the Prince's Trust Macquarie Youth Index, and as you say, it's the biggest survey of its kind. And the good news, first of all, is that most young people are happy with most aspects of their lives, but a significant minority do experience a range of mental health and emotional well-being issues, and amongst the unemployed young people, that situation seems to be very much worse.
Mm. Now, Nat, your story, I know you were enduring a difficult home life compounded by autism and dyslexia. Then your dad left home, which left you without any money. Your mum suffered a breakdown. I mean, how did you cope with all that?
It really wasn't easy to cope, to be honest. I found myself losing weight drastically through not eating, my education and grades suffering dramatically. I didn't really know where to turn to, and I didn't really know the organisations or who could help me. As far as I was concerned, I was the only one feeling this way, and I felt particularly isolated in the world.
Yeah, and your GCSEs at the time were looming as well. Did that make it even worse?
It did, because, I mean, at that age, your GCSEs are meant to be one of the most important things that is going on in your life. But for me, it was just a minor thing. Everything else was so gigantic that my GCSEs kind of got brushed to the side, which obviously will leave me in a disadvantage for the rest of my life if it wasn't for the Prince's Trust.
Mm. And this going out part of this research, was that your example then, that you basically got house-trapped?
Yeah, completely. It got to the stage where I was so terrified of something bad happening at my house or losing my mother that I just never wanted to leave. I just in case something would go wrong, it was always on my mind. If I used to ever try to leave the house or be social, I'd start feeling sick and dizzy and really heavy. And in the end, it was just easier just to stay in bed and not to leave.
Right. I mean, Sean, this is echoes of what you were telling us in the last hour again.
It is complete echoes of what I said. Like, it's almost the same story, just being, feel like you're trapped within yourself, that you don't want to let anyone in because you feel like you're going to hurt everyone or let people down.
Nat, Sean also said earlier that he thinks that technology, in a way, is making it easier to get trapped at home because you've got your tablet, perhaps your mobile and so on, and in a way it becomes a vicious circle where you can still have friendships online as well, perhaps as a backup, and then you don't need to go out. I wonder what you think about that.
That's a really interesting point, and I can completely understand that. For me, online was my only really outlet. It's at times when I wouldn't leave the house for months at a time.
Really?
Chatting to people on Skype or Facebook was the only time I actually felt like I had friends. But you're right, it kind of traps you in a way. So I felt like I didn't need to go out because I had that people, but you really do need real interaction.
Paul, what do you make of that part of it? Is social media, it has many benefits, but actually for this particular age group, can it be a bit of a curse because you get trapped into thinking, oh, I have got a social life, but it's actually only online?
Yeah, I think it's definitely a double-edged sword. Yes, it connects people with the outside world. It also lets bullies into your household, and that's another aspect that came through in our survey.
Really?
You know, young people can have the front door closed, but the bullies can still get into their home through social media, so there are definitely pros and cons.
Sean's nodding at that.
Yeah.
Do you agree with that, Sean?
No, I do agree with that. There are people online that aren't nice.
And does that then make you worse about not wanting to go out because you feel threatened by it?
Yeah, you do.
Fascinating. Look, now, I've got to ask you before we go, there's a happy ending because the Prince's Trust helped you, and you graduated from Bournemouth University. So how did they make the difference?
The Prince's Trust they gave me the confidence to believe in myself. And the most important thing I got from them was not how to do certain subjects, but how to teach myself. And from then it was a snowball effect. They were with me every step of the way from the start of my university adventure to right up until I graduated. I honestly love life now, and I'm so proud to have graduated from Bournemouth University. And I've now moved to London. I've got an independent life. I've got a full-time job.
Brilliant.
I couldn't be happier.
Nat, thank you very much for sharing your story. Paul and all of you at the Prince's Trust should be inspired by these stories today. Thank you for being there.
A real pleasure. Thank you.
Cheers, Paul. Thank you, Nat.